According to the Steam Hardware Survey, the core components in this system is what you're using right now to watch this video, unless you're on the toilet watching it on your phone, which is equally as likely. But if you're using a computer, you have this hardware. And if you don't have the hardware components in here, then I'm not an expert, but I'm pretty sure this is how stats work. It means that you don't exist. So you should probably have that checked out. And while you're busy figuring that problem out for yourself, the rest of us are gonna see what kind of gaming experience you get with the most common components in the most common games. Because I wanna get to know the gaming experience that you're having at the moment a little bit better. You know, maybe we can snuggle up on the couch after and discuss some game settings. But before we do that, today's video is sponsored by Be Quiet's brand new light loop AIOs. If you want some pump block illumination, then here you go. This is the AIO for you. It's about as RGB as a pump block can get, and despite its charisma boost, it hasn't sacrificed in its performance stat. It's also got a fill port which helps with long-term maintenance, very cool. Available in both black, white, and in sizes up to 360mm. So if you want an AIO to strap a window AC to, check out Be Quiet's new light loop AIOs using the link down below. Wow, I just recorded this whole section and my mic was off. I am a professional, I'm good at this. Now first off, we want to have a look at the Steam Hardware Survey to know what system we need to use. And we're going to start off with operating system, which this wasn't a surprise to me at all. Windows 11 at 48.8%, which is up 1.11%. So it's won over a little bit more market share from Windows 10, which is the second most popular, at 45.46. They're very close, and basically we're all using Windows, one of those two. It's all of us. Very good news is that OS X, just 1.39% of Steam users are on a Mac, which, suck it, Apple, you're losing at something, and I hope that keeps you up at night. And then finally, Linux, just 2% of people are gaming on Linux, which is kind of funny to me. And also, I said it correctly, which I think means I deserve a sub off that. Yes, Linux. Linux. Next up, we want to see how much RAM people are using these days, and this one's also quite predictable at 16 gigs. Although what is interesting about this result to me is that it's gone up, and the second most popular, 32 gigs, it's actually gone down. So I guess that means people are downgrading from 32 gigs to 16 gigs. So either one of your sticks of RAM died, or you need the 3 cents that exchange is gonna net you for like a Genshin Impact loot boxes or whatever. Now next up is CPUs, which we're gonna need to do a little bit of investigation here because Steam's a little bit vague about it. It tells us that, you know, the split between Intel and AMD and whatever, but it doesn't give us specific product SKUs. So we're gonna have to figure that out. This result was interesting to me because 65.49% of people are still using Intel, and it's only down 1.21%, which doesn't make sense to me considering that the company has been actively imploding for the last year, but apparently that doesn't impact their market share very much. Also, Microsoft making some fat gains here. Now, in terms of cores, 6 cores is the most popular. Although this is down, people do seem to be upgrading CPU cores while downgrading RAM. That's a bit weird because, you know, the people who upgraded their cores are definitely the ones that downgraded their RAM. Now the next CPU metric is speed, which is a little bit of an arbitrary thing for me to have them measure, like, is it boost frequency? Although, considering the most popular result being 2.3 gigahertz to 2.69 gigahertz, nice, I think that means it's base frequency. And that implies we're looking at an i5 of some description. So I decided to go with an Intel i5-12400. It meets our specs perfectly, and it's a very popular CPU that I think represents modern i5 performance very well. Now with graphics cards, luckily Steam is a little bit less opaque with it. It just tells you what the graphics card is. And it's an RTX 3060, which I think makes sense. 5.59% of people have one of those, which that's quite a big market share for a single graphics card to have, even though it's down minus 0.1-ish%. The second most popular, which is also down for some reason, is a laptop RTX 4060, followed by a desktop 4060. And then the fourth entry is the GTX 1650, which for a very long time was the most popular Steam graphics card. In fact, for a while, I was convinced there was a natural geyser somewhere that just produces them because they were very readily available. A sad part of the GPU market share is there's no AMD. People really don't like AMD very much. In fact, there's a lot more Intel iGPU than any AMD GPU. So we should probably think about that. That's a bit of a bad result. Moving on. video memory, or VRAM for short, if you're from the streets. 8 gigs is the most popular. Now, fun fact, in terms of video memory, 0.66% of you still have 128 megs of video memory, which, now that I've said it out loud, that's not really a fun fact, that's quite sad. 128 megs is very, very little. I hope things get better for you. it's not great. I think it may have something to do with iGPUs, but still, that is a higher percentage than I was expecting. The final important performance one is resolution. And if you can't guess what this one is, then it means that you're probably a normal person and not a massive nerd like I am. But it's 1080p. At 56.98% market share. Now again, this stat is interesting because it's gone up by 1.25%, whereas the second most popular, which is 1440p and the kind of like upgrade of it, which has gone down by 1.7%. And considering that like 4K and ultra wide and stuff hasn't also gone up, the implication here, at least as far as I understand how to read data, is that you're all downgrading from 1440p to 1080p. Is that what's happening? Like, let me know in the comment section down below if you're doing that. That is an interesting thing. We have seen a bit of a trend of specs getting a little bit worse over time, except for CPU cores. You all love some CPU cores. Now, the final two stats aren't super important, but they're interesting. Languages, the most popular is Chinese, but it's actually down 3%, which is a huge change, and English is up almost 2%. So I guess a bunch of people who speak Chinese have become English, is the takeaway from that. And then finally, hard drives. The most popular hard drive capacity, like total capacity for your system, is 1 terabyte, although that's also down 0.81%. So a bunch of us had hard drives die in the last while, which condolences, that's a little bit sad. And yeah, with that, we know what system we need to build. So let's throw all of the components into the PC and then see how it runs. Now, a quick point in terms of our RAM configuration. Steam doesn't specify speed or even type of RAM, so I've used DDR4 running at 3600 MHz, but we'll see what slower RAM does to our performance a bit later. Counter-Strike will never go away. It is always number one. It is going to be the king of gaming for as long as we live. It runs really well. It's a super easy to run game. We're getting 200. We're getting between 200 and 300 frames per second at 1080p. This is with low settings. This is how I understand you should play the game. Although, look at what's happening here. In terms of utilization, there's not a whole lot going on, and that means that we're not getting that much of frame rate. And my theory for why this was happening was that CS2 was choking out just one of the cores on our CPU. So to see if this was correct, I brought up utilization for all of the cores. So in terms of CPU utilization, you can see that most of the hyper-threading cores aren't really doing much, and most of the load is on CPU1. That's the thing that is working the hardest here. Now, it could be worse, but 76% is pretty high utilization for a CPU core, so it's likely the reason we're not getting more utilization and more frame rate, but the game is running very well. We may not be breaking the sound barrier with frame rate, but it's more than good enough. So I decided to drop the RAM speed to 2666 MHz to see what impact that has on the performance. And just that change lost us over 10% of our performance, which isn't insignificant. This is still a thing. We're still doing this, are we? That's very fun. Banana. So Banana's happening at 60 frames per second. Clearly a very demanding game. Halloween graphics really just making the system work. No. We gotta crank it up to 1080p. Suspiciously blurry Banana happening, but it sits at 60 frames per second. So if you are a Banana enthusiast, which apparently it's the second most popular game on Steam, so you statistically are very likely to be a Banana enthusiast, the system handles it very well. Now with Dota, we're not gonna get into too much detail here because it's a game that you can run on a 70s Casio ARM watch, but
here it's running at 1080p with the settings maxed out. And we're kind of hovering around 200 frames per second, which is where the game lives, pretty much.
Even here, with all of the particle effects happening, it's still running very well. So the 3060 handles the crap out of this game. I do want to test all of these games with the 1650 later in the video, just so that we can see how much more performance we've gotten since that was the most popular graphics card. We've got a couple more games to go before that. Call of Duty is interesting because I've not tested it in ages, and the first thing I learned about it was that downloading it is super annoying. It downloads in several phases, so every time you finish your 100 gig download thinking it's done, it just jumps another one on you, which is really fun. But once I got into Call of Duty 17 Black Ops 12, it ran decently. Now at 1080p balanced, it's running pretty well. We're hovering about 90 frames per second. It varies, but that's kind of where it's averaging. And yeah, for single player, it feels pretty good. Although, I would probably want a bit more frame rate for a fast-paced game like this playing multiplayer, but I'll try that out a bit later. First, I'm curious to see what the different settings do. I then switched over to the recommended preset, which pushed the settings quite a bit higher and still left it at native 1080p. Oh wow, that's a big dip in frame rate. It seems like recommended's kind of targeting 60 frames per second, which, I mean, console-wise, I guess makes sense. It feels okay, but it's not quite as snappy as I'd like. I then jumped into a multiplayer lobby where it was definitely playable at recommended settings, but this is not how I would recommend running the game. I then dropped the settings to basic, which netted me some frame rate, but it still wasn't running as fast as I wanted it to. So I turned on DLSS at balanced, which looked decent and ran very well. And with DLSS on, you can jump the settings up a decent bit again if you want to do that, but either way, this game seems pretty reliant on upscaling. And then finally, the number 5 spot again, it's been here for ages, PUBG. This is it running at 1080p high settings, and it's not going as good as I was expecting. I mean, this is a huge view, but we're getting under 100 frames per second. Ooh, and that utilization is also not going great, although it's PUBG, so a lack of optimization kind of checks out. Let's see what happens when we use like Fortnite settings, drop everything to low, and just have super view distance. Okay, that's helped a bit, although it does vary wildly based on what we're looking at. Now, when looking at what all of the cores are doing, it's a little different to what CS2 is doing. We've got a bit more of a spread of utilization over all of the cores. But yeah, I mean, it's PUBG. This game is pretty much renowned for its lack of optimization. And either way, it's still running very well. And then the final thing I wanted to do was drop a GTX 1650 into the system to see how far we've come in most popular graphics card performance. And the difference was interesting, because with CS2, it wasn't that big a gap because there were other constraints holding the system back, so it's not as devastating a humiliation as you'd expect. Whereas with a demanding game like Call of Duty 47, the difference is huge, it's more than double. And with that, my main takeaway from this video is that Activision needs to figure out its Call of Duty downloading situation, because this madness is an abomination and they should be ashamed of themselves. Which brings me to the end of the video. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed it, watch another video, a suggestion will pop up, subscribe to the channel, and until the next one, bye-bye.